Stinking and stinking left, right, left, hook.
See any kid on the block? Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
They're slugging it out. A left to the jaw. Press this lever. He throws a right. The other a left.
And the winner is...
The Sage, Larry Elder.
Guys, I want to ask you both one thing. There's universal agreement on this. President has acted swiftly. He tasked the Department of Justice, the Civil Rights Division, and the FBI to expedite this case specifically and early. They have a prosecutor in Minnesota, reported by CBS in Minnesota, local CBS. His name is Mike Freeman, and he's saying that there's other evidence here that, quote, does not support a criminal charge. He said that yesterday. His office then issues a clarification saying his comment was being misinterpreted. But the clarification really didn't clarify what did he mean by other evidence. Now, however, if the county attorney indeed has evidence that would change people's minds on this, why wouldn't he have released it immediately? Because what everybody's watching on TV, nobody likes. So, and the exact words were, and there is other evidence that does not support a criminal charge. We need to weigh through all of that evidence to come through with a meaningful determination, and we're doing the best of our ability, he said. Larry Elder, you're a lawyer. Leo Terrell, you're a lawyer. Larry, what is he talking about?
Two words, John. Dennis Nifong. You remember that DA?
Oh, yeah.
The Duke DA.
Duke Lacrosse.
Publicly said that these boys were guilty, I'm going to get you, and so he got disbarred. A job of a prosecutor is to do justice, and this prosecutor has to get the evidence, and clearly there's stuff we don't know, and then determine what charges, if any, ought to be filed against these four officers. In my opinion, I can't imagine there not being charges against the officers. Don't know what they are. I can't imagine all of them being equally culpable, but maybe they are. But the point is, a DA's job is to get the information, make sure he has a prosecutable case, and that he can win that case. And that is what this DA is doing. I think you're going to have a problem, Sean, when you fire four officers without one word of testimony being taken. Even bad officers are entitled to due process and are presumed to be innocent. And in my opinion, there's going to be another lawsuit by these four officers arguing that their civil rights were violated.
Leo.
Very simple. First of all, I want to kudos, and I say very loud, kudos to President Trump getting the federal government involved immediately. Great job. Secondly, I think it's overwhelming evidence to establish probable cause for these officers, especially the one who knelt down on Mr. Floyd, to be arrested and charged with at least involuntary manslaughter. And my understanding is that the person who did that officer has been arrested and taken into custody. So I think the federal government and the state government, with all their collective resources, are moving as quickly as possible, negating those protesters to make that statement, no justice, no peace. That statement does not apply here because there's been swift action. I agree with Larry. These officers, let's follow the law. Due process, they're entitled to. But there is no doubt about it. The officer, the main culprit, is arrested. He's going to be charged. And again, the federal and state government working together, they got overwhelming evidence and resources to charge not only the officer, the principal officer, but the other officers as well.